Hey, I'm going to show you step by step how to safely and securely cash out your Bitcoin from a hardware wallet to your bank account in a few easy steps. Just follow along. The last step's really important. That's where most people mess up, so make sure you watch until the end. Firstly, we're going to get your Bitcoin that's sitting in your hardware wallet, such as the one in my hand, into an exchange. Then we're going to need to sell those Bitcoins for currency. We're going to make sure that your exchange is set up correctly for accepting withdrawals into your bank account. And we're then going to finally make that cash withdrawal into your bank account. Step one, let's get our Bitcoin from our hardware wallet into an exchange. This will work regardless of which hardware wallet you have. I'm using the Trezor, as you can see, but this works exactly the same for the Ledger, Nano, as well as Tangem, or any other hardware wallet you have. So firstly, to get your Bitcoin from your hardware wallet into your exchange account, you need to log into the software. So in my instance, I'm using the Trezor suite. If you've got a Ledger, it'll be Ledger Live. And similarly, if you've got Tangem, you'll need to use the app. What I'm going to do here in this step is send my Bitcoin from my Trezor, so from my hardware wallet account. I'm going to send it and I'm going to then receive it into my exchange account. So if you haven't already got an exchange, Coinbase is probably the most widely used, followed by Kraken and Binance. So you need to have an exchange set up. So in your exchange, you want to receive crypto, but I'm just going to go to Bitcoin first. Okay, I want to receive crypto. I want to receive Bitcoin through the Bitcoin network. And that's going to display your receive address, right? Let's copy that receive address. Done. Now, into our hardware wallet platform, I need to go to send because I want to send the Bitcoin that exists here. And I'm then going to right click and paste the receive address I just copied from my exchange. Enter the amount of Bitcoin you want to send. Okay. I like to leave everything else as default. I'm then going to review and send. Now, in my instance, as you can see here, it's asking me to verify that the address that I see on the screen is what I'm seeing on the device. So let me just continue that on my device. It's asking me to confirm the amount of Bitcoin I want to send. So I'll confirm. I've signed the transaction, which now enables the send button here. So I'll now click send, and as you can see, the expected wait time is around 20 minutes today. Okay, the send has begun, and you should be able to see the transaction in the history. It will come up as pending until it's completed. So now I'm going to wait the 20 minutes and then refresh my exchange account where I will have received the Bitcoin. I've waited 15 minutes and I can see the Bitcoin that I've sent has now arrived successfully. So that's step one completed. Step two, let's sell our Bitcoin for currency. So let's go into the Bitcoin. What we're going to want to do is sell. If you're using Coinbase, just a quick tip that the fees when sending with advanced are a little bit lower. In my instance, I'm doing it with a very small test transaction, so I'm not going to worry too much about that. But that's just a bit of a side note if you're interested and you're selling large amounts. So we've gone to sell. We want to sell our Bitcoin and we want to sell it to currency. Now, mine's obviously showing Australian dollars. Yours should show your particular currency. Enter the amount of Bitcoin that you want to sell, either in Bitcoin or dollars. Let's review the order. You can then see the fees that your exchange is charging to make that transaction. I'm just using a small test transaction, hence a high percentage of fee. And when you're ready, you can sell that for currency. And that's done. That's instantaneous. That's step two complete. Step three and four are where most people get confused and stuff up. So just pay close attention to these. Now we'll make sure that our exchange is set up to be able to make withdrawals. So in your exchange, look for the withdrawal link. So withdraw cash. Here's the part that catches people out. If your exchange doesn't allow you to actually make the withdrawal, that's because your bank account is not connected yet to the exchange. The way to connect your bank account, unfortunately, is you must make a deposit first. By making a deposit, even if it's $5 or $10 to your exchange, what that does is act as a way of validating your bank account and therefore enable you to make a withdrawal. If you haven't done that, you won't be able to make the withdrawal. And if you have done that, you should be able to see your bank account come up as an option for the instant cash out of your funds. So I'm going to pick the account that I want to cash out to and continue. The fee in this instance is nil. And when you're ready, you can cash out. Okay, the request is sent. And I've just received a notification to tell me that my cash has landed in my bank account, and that was done instantaneously with Coinbase because I've had previous transaction history with them. Now again, if you're unable to withdraw, you'll need to press deposit cash, transfer cash using the method shown on the screen, and that will enable and activate the ability for you to then withdraw cash. So if you've just signed up for a new exchange, that's the process you'll have to follow as a one-off, and it's worth it in the long term. If you have any questions about any of that, please do ask in the comments below. Let's have a conversation and let's help each other out, because it should be a really simple and straightforward process to securely cash your Bitcoin out from your hardware wallet to your bank account in a matter of about 10 minutes.